protein, protein, protein. Everyone loves telling us how important protein is for our muscles. Some even made it into a slogan. Can you believe that? But in this video, we're going to find out if it really is that important, or can you still get all the good muscle gains without the protein gains? When it comes to building muscle, experts often recommend getting about 1.6 or more grams of protein per kilogram of body weight per day. However, this is not exactly feasible for everyone, both digestively and even financially, since many gym goers require purchasing protein supplements to reach these higher levels of protein. So if we do eat less than what is considered optimal, what can we really expect to happen? Looking through the research, one thing's for sure is that eating less protein does lead to less gains. But in terms of how much, it varies wildly from one study to the next. Which makes sense if we think about it. Protein, as important as it may be, is really only one factor among many factors in the fitness equation. So to deal with this variability, it's probably best to go over research reviews, evaluating all the relevant data and condensing it for us into more practical insights. One of which is a 2020 systematic review, where Tagawa and colleagues analyzed 66 relevant studies to evaluate a dose-response relationship between protein intake and lean mass gains. In their findings, based on an average intervention period of 20 weeks, they observed that for every 0.1 grams of protein per kilogram added to your diet, lean mass gains go up by 0.39 kilograms until you reach 1.3 grams of protein per kilogram, where then it goes up by only 0.12 kilograms. This review is one of the few, if not the only, research that extrapolated the data this way, giving us a visual and statistical insight on the relationship between lean mass gains and protein intakes. I do want to point out, though, that there was a wide range of subject populations included in this review. And although they did adjust for some factors like age, sex, and training, there are many other factors to consider. Perhaps a more relevant data set for people watching this video is from a 2018 systematic review, where Morton and colleagues investigated similar outcomes but narrowed their scope to healthy young adults participating in resistance training. Although they did not evaluate the specific effect sizes, they did produce their own figure showing the magnitude of the dose-response relationship of protein intake and lean mass. And when we compare this figure to the figure from the previous review, the trends aren't all that much different. In fact, when the 2022 data is further adjusted for weight changes, since a lot of its data came from weight loss studies, they become even more similar. If there's only one thing you take away from this video, it should be these figures. Both show clearly that you can build muscle at lower protein intakes, but notably less the less protein you eat. But if you gradually increase your protein, then you can further enhance your growth. A few more tidbits worth mentioning. Older folks generally require more protein to stave off muscle loss, but they tend to respond the least with higher protein intakes when paired with resistance training. If you're cutting, more protein is important, as is resistance training, to preserve your muscles and improve fat loss. Beginners respond really well to resistance training early on, even at lower protein intakes. So if you're new, you do have some time to figure out your protein. In the 2018 review, the researchers found that trained individuals responded the best with higher protein intakes, recommending as much as 2.2 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight per day for those wanting to fully maximize their growth. However, 1.6 should be fine for most. Before we close, let's go back once more to the figures. Yeah, you will build less muscle if you eat less protein, but you will still build muscle. Just make sure that you are resistance training, like lifting weights, on a regular basis. Down the line, if you can change your protein situation, then great, but don't feel like it's not worth pushing for your goals just because you're not getting the supposed optimal levels of protein. Getting close enough can still lead to great results, so keep at it. And that's it for this one. I hope you found this video useful. Also, please consider supporting the channel by becoming a channel member. It will help a lot, and I appreciate it so much. Other than that, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a lean thumbs up and share it with your muscle-loving friends. Subscribe for more. As always, thank you for watching, and the best slogan in the world, don't forget to get your protein, even if it's a little bit.